Afternoon, Gary.
Afternoon.
Swansea in ninth, 10 games to go. How do you assess the season?
Yeah, good, up to this point. 10 games left, all to play for. All the teams fighting for different reasons. Yeah, but we're in a healthy position in the league. It's somewhere where we've been in the top 10 the whole season. So it's something that we're fighting for to make sure that we remain there come the end of the season.
Are you pleased with the season so far? Is it better than perhaps your expectations from the summer?
Of course I'm pleased. I think the way we've adapted and, you know, a big transition over the summer and obviously a new manager in terms of where we've been at. But sorry, the phone's just going off there. But no, I've been happy with it. We've got plenty of improvement to go, plenty of more things to work on as a group. But no, we're working in a very good way. We've done very well so far this season. Been very happy with the majority of our performances and just looking to really finish the season strong with the 10 games left.
Three wins in your last six, one of them against Man United, one of them against Southampton. So you enter this last phase of the season really confident. How much will those results give you belief that you can have a really strong end to the season?
Oh, we're a confident group. We've got some very good players. They work extremely well for each other and a great team spirit. But I think that's carried us through all the season so far. So I don't envisage that changing at all. The last 10 games, we just have to focus game by game. The next game's on Monday night. So we have to be fully focused on that. Make sure that we put 100% of the commitment and desire that we showed in all those games that you talked about and that we show our quality as well, because that's the one thing we have. We have big quality. So we're trying to show that in all the remaining games and make sure that we finish it strong and make sure that we can be remembered for some good things this season.
As you've touched upon there, you're back in action on Monday night in Monday Night Football. Liverpool, you've been up against them twice before. You've lost on both occasions, once in the cup, once in the league. How determined are you that you get this right, third time lucky?
Yeah, for sure. You try and win every game. No, the league game we had up there, we deserved to lose the game. We didn't perform at our best that night and Liverpool deserved to win the game. The cup game itself, well, I think it was very harsh. There were certain circumstances which led to that result. So, but no, Liverpool, very, very good side, very strong, great quality, obviously pushing for a top four place now, which is very tight up there. So, but like I said before, we've got our own agenda, our own targets to try and go for and hopefully it'd be a good game. I think it'd be an entertaining game with two good sides and we'll be looking to, especially at home, in front of our crowd on a Monday night, live on the Sky cameras, we'll be hopefully putting a good show for the home crowd.
When you look at Liverpool's recent run of results and how well they're doing at the moment, are you coming up against them at the right time or the wrong time?
Well, they're probably the most formed team in the league right now and, yeah, playing extremely well and great talent all over the pitch. A high quality squad, they've got, you know, dangerous players all over the pitch. So, of course, we have to be mindful of that, but I think we're working well this week on ourselves and obviously we identify the strengths of Liverpool, try to nullify them, but put our own quality and our own way of playing into the game. And I think we do that very well. And especially at home, like I said in the, you know, before, it's important for us to make sure that we get on the front foot, we get the crowd with us and we make sure that we make sure it's a proper game against Liverpool. But one that we're all excited. I think everyone, whenever you play a Liverpool, that type of name, I think all the players get excited by it, the crowd and the city itself, so looking forward to it.
Obviously, there's always the links as well between the two clubs. Does it perhaps mean more than any other Premier League game? When you look at the, you know, the Brendan Rodgers and obviously the Joe Allens, the John Joes, and there's a lot of links between the two clubs.
Yeah, there's a lot of links. So there's that side of it, but no, 3 points is always important. The most important part of any game is the 3 points, so that's what we always fight for. We look for that no matter who we're playing, and of course there's those links, which would be great. It'd be good to see Brendan and his backroom staff, Joe Allen as well, who left our club, so it'd be great to see all them. But no, the focus is on 3 points, our performance in front of our fans and making sure that we can try and come away with them.
You're obviously continually developing as a manager. Now you've obviously, you know, well into the season, how much of Brendan have you taken into your own management style?
Someone
obviously manage yourself.
I just think what you do yourself as a manager is, and you know, I look at all my experiences in football, all the managers I've played under, and the good and the bad experiences that I've had as a player, and I think you take those experiences and you try and be yourself. I don't try and be anyone else. There's no point in being anyone else because I think players look straight through you. So I'm just myself. I have my own plan in my own mind of how I want to do training, how I want my team to play, how to go forward. as a manager with my team, and that's why I implement. But obviously those experiences under good managers and other managers that may be done something that you probably didn't agree with or things like that, I think you use those experiences to pull it into your way of managing. So that's what I'm trying to do, but very much myself, not trying to be anyone else.
As for Swansea this season, 40 points at the moment. Your best ever points tally in the Premier League is 47. How confident are you you can beat that and this can be the best ever season in the history of the club?
Well, we've probably got the best chance of beating that total that we can have at this point. So it's definitely something that we're gunning for and looking for and going to push and fight for. That's our motivation right there. And I don't think we can focus on anything else. But of course, there's a process to get to that point. So it's 3 points on Monday. That's the next 3 points that we can get closer to that tally. That's what we'll be fighting for. And hopefully we can get there sooner rather than later. But of course, that's a realistic target for us to try and beat, and that'd be a great achievement if we can get there.
And finally for me, with 10 games to go, we've already spoken about it, have you got yourself a target, have you set yourself a points finish or anything like that at all?
No, not so much a final total or anything like that. I think I talked about trying to get to the 40 point mark as soon as we could, hopefully leave games to spare, which we've done. So those 10 games now, that it's important that we try and, like you just talked about, that 47 points is the next target. Let's get to that. Let's try and beat that. And hopefully if we can do that and still have some games to spare after that, then obviously it'd be further targets after that. But I'm not looking too far ahead. I'm just looking for the next target, which is 47 points. Yeah.
Garry, Baffert and Gomis returned to training the week. Can you sort of tell us how he's been in training and likelihood of him playing on Monday and how he's doing in general?
No, he's fine. Normal procedure for us. Obviously, he went for his check. He went to the hospital as precautionary straight after the game, or that night, after the Tottenham game as precaution. And obviously, the hospital there ran their tests. Obviously, liaised with his consultant he's had his whole life back in France. And everything was fine. All the monitoring that they did after the game was fine. And it was really just to check that there was nothing untoward. But I've said before, you know, unfortunately, Baffy's had to live with this his whole life. It's nothing major in his life. It's to us, ourselves, we're very well aware of it as a club, as a medical team, and myself as a manager. So it's not such a big deal to us. Obviously, to the outside world, at a ground that's had that history with it as well, obviously it gets highlighted, and I can understand why totally. And of course, it's concerning when you see things like that. But we also know that it's not majorly, you know, a difficult thing for Baffy to deal with. He's had it his whole life, so it's just one of them things, and unfortunately it happened to him. But you know, as far as Baffy's concerned, he's fine, come straight out, released from hospital that next morning, and resume as normal, back in training, his usual self, and away we go.
Because I know you mentioned that it was something that you checked before he signed.
Yeah.
Something that he's had before.
Yeah.
He even said that he wanted to go back on the pitch. If it was to happen again, would it just be a case of having to substitute him and leave him out for the rest of the game? How would you deal with it?
It's the same. It's not exactly the same, but it's the same sort of situation as if you had concussion. You know, I've had it myself. I've been concussed in the game and played on and feel fine. But ethically and medically, it's not the right thing to do, and you have to bring him off. Baffy was on the stretcher screaming and shouting that he wanted to play on, but unfortunately, you can't do that. So it's just a procedure you have to go through. And quite rightly so as well. We're totally aware of that. Baffy is as well. As much as a player would like to stay on in those situations, you can't do it. But like I said before, it's not something that happens very often with Baffy. But when it does, we're in the right place. We've got the right people around it to deal with it. And we move on very quickly, because as long as Baffy, the only concern is Baffy. Make sure he's okay and ready to go. And like I said, he's had all the medical procedures that you can possibly have for that type of thing. And these are from the top specialists in the world that have done this, and there's no problems. They've all okayed him fit to carry on with his career, and he's had it his whole career anyway. So, like I said, it's business as normal.
And as far as the rest of the squad goes, are you dealing with a fully fit squad in the Liverpool game?
Yeah, apart from obviously Carl Bartley. He's still in the treatment room, but shouldn't be too much longer. And the rest is a fully fit squad, yeah.
And with the increased competition that you've got now following your January signings, the likes of Jack Cork coming in, how do you go about selecting a team against Liverpool? Jonjo Shelvey, of course, had a bit of an eventful time up at Anfield. What have you made of his progression since then?
No, he's done fantastic. He had a great month. Last 4 or 5 games, Jonjo's really stepped up and put in some very good performances, as has the team itself, all the players that have been involved. And And it all comes from the training field. The group are pushing very hard together, very much, you know, working hard for each other and pushing each other every single day, which is what you want as a manager. It's great to see. And then, you know, use this time in between, see how they are, see how get the feel for the group and make your judgments on team selection as the week goes on. So that's where I'm at right now. I haven't selected the team, but they're training very well, very hard decisions to make. But, you know, come Monday, hopefully we're firing and I'm ready to go. No, of course not. But no, like I said, I have to see how the week goes and what I feel is good for that game. But just felt at that point that the players needed a new challenge to freshen it up a little bit, something to focus on, and of course tactical reasons as well that we thought would work, and that's why we made those changes in the recent game. So, but I think that's good. I've talked to it, about it before. It's important that as a football team you're adaptable and you can. You can change within games or at start of games or end of games and have something else for the opposition to think about. So that's what I'm trying to work towards with the group, and they've taken it on board very, very well. So hopefully we get to see a little bit more of both or a few things come towards the end of the season.
Garry, Brendan's been very clear this week about when you were playing for him, what he saw in you, the huge potential that he saw in you in terms of moving on into management. When he was your boss, what was he like to play under, and what potential did you see in him?
I said before, I just think he was what we needed at that time. He was a breath of fresh air when he walked in, very honest, very approachable, very detailed in the way that he worked. But you just got the impression that he was as hungry as us for success and to do well and to push on. And he'd obviously had some good experiences and some bad experiences in his career up to that point, and felt that it was a great opportunity for him here to really push on in his career, and it proved the point. You know, in the two seasons that he was here, got us promoted, and then that first season in the Premiership where we did fantastically well. So yeah, you could see the potential from the start, and what I liked mostly about him was his honesty and his way of working. The detail he did on the football pitch, on the training ground every day was very, very good and really enjoyable, and we all learned a great deal from that point. So yeah, obviously that they were the biggest factors behind what he did.
He's got quite a reputation as a good man manager. Is that something that you've had experience of? And is it something, in terms of what you learned from him, that perhaps was one of the biggest factors?
I think that's one of his biggest strengths, for sure. He always includes you, always talks to you. And it's not just about football. It can be personal things or life in general, which is... And I don't think he did it out of... trying to be clever. I think he did it out of genuine interest as well. You know, it wasn't just, oh, I better talk to him about this or that side of things just because that sounds like it's a good thing to be doing. I think he genuinely was interested in how you lived your life and how you went about things and what you thought about certain subjects. So he was very good at that. And obviously there were some tactical bits within it of his thinking. So very clever man as well, which came across, but always did it in an honest way, which is what you want as a player. And whether you liked what he said or you didn't like what he said, you respected it. So I think that's a big strength for any manager, but especially one of Brendan's.
And you know, I know that the most important thing to you is the 3 points every time, but I wonder whether pitting your wits against somebody like Brendan, who you like and respect as well, does that add an extra frisson to a match like this, or is it literally practicalities just get the 3 points in the bag?
I think it's practicality, but of course, you know, if you come up against someone with Brendan's experience, where he's at now and the level that he's managing and what he's trying to do and move the club forward, it's, of course, you're trying to pit your wits and try and improve yourself and try and get closer to what they're doing and closer to competing against those types of teams. And of course they have, you know, when you talk in terms of the sizes of clubs and budgets and all that sort of thing, they're probably a million miles away from what we are. So but you're trying to compete with that and trying to get closer to them every time that you compete against them. So we were disappointed with our league game up there earlier on in the season. We look to put that right in this game, and hopefully we close that gap a little bit more and can compete that much better than what we did in the first game.
In your preparations, does it help that you know him?
Not really, to be honest with you. I think you look at, in your preparations, you always analyse the opposition and look at their strengths and weaknesses and players and what way you think they might set up and might do within a game or changes they might make within a game. And you try and work around that, but always putting your side of things, making sure the boys focus on what we do best. And so in terms of knowing him, I don't think it's a case of really, it gives you an upper hand. I think it's just obviously You obviously know the way he works and what he'd be expecting more from his team, so which allows you to prepare your team in the way that you wanted to be able to compete with that.
And I know you say he was always meticulous in his preparation, and I know that's something that you do as well, and you're very practical about it. I mean, we've talked in the past about psychological advantages, sometimes being on home territory and that sort of thing, and I know you're sort of, it's not a huge thing as far as you're concerned, but you know, they are in a decent vein of form, it has to be said. But then they've never beaten you here at the Liberty Stadium. Do any of those factors ever come into play in your thinking?
I think they do from the outside. I think when people like to talk about stats and history and things like that, and they look back over, they see stats like that, and I guess whether that plays on players' minds, I don't think so, to be honest with you. I don't think you really think, oh, we've never beaten a team here, or we've never lost here, or we've won, always won here. I don't think that really plays on the mind. I think when it's mentioned, probably then, you know, players will think about that, or if that gives them confidence or not. But you know, we just try and focus on our jobs, focus on the game plan, try and execute that as best as possible. And the other bit is to try and put an entertaining performance on as well whilst we're doing it. But that's always difficult to do. It's never easy to be able to do that, but that's always the aim. So especially home here, where our fans have been fantastic this season. We've had some great games, and under the Sky cameras as well, we've had some good games. So hopefully it's another one, but one that we can get a win from.
Last one's for me, just on the subject of Angel. I mean, great news that he signed a contract extension. Just sum up how important he is here. In terms of, you know, does he act? I mean, I know you've got Ashley on the pitch as your skipper, but you know, people like Angel, the experience that they've got, are they sort of like extra generals on the pitch?
Yeah, for sure. And around the group, training every single day. Angel, probably the most competitive player in the squad. I spoke to him this week actually about the way that, you know, it's a difficult situation, it's a tough decision. You know, Carl's playing at the moment with Angel pushing him hard, but the way he's conducted himself and pushing everyone, pushes himself, and the way he acts around the group is, you know, he's been fantastic, and he deserves that contract extension. Players like him that's been through everything understand how that we work, how the club work, what it means to a lot of people, to the community and everyone. You need people like that within the squad to help promote that, but not just that, he's a good player as well, Angel, and if anything, he's unlucky not to be playing right now, so still plenty of time for Angel. He still have his games, and he's an important part for me, for myself as well as a manager now, is going forward with the squad that I've got.
Very briefly, I mean, it's difficult, I guess, when you've got the relationship you've got with him to make those sorts of decisions, or is it not difficult? Is it literally that clinical, I've got to put the best man out on the pitch?
Well, they know, it's not necessarily that, it's just these are the decisions you have to make. They understand that. Players won't always agree with your decisions. They're every right not to, but what it is you ask for respect from what you're doing, and I'm very honest and open with them and try and explain my point when needs be to tell them these situations. But Angel's, you know, very understanding, and that relationship, of course, it helps when you have been here many years now with Angel and played a lot of games with him and have that understanding with him, but that doesn't mean he accepts those decisions. But he's very respectful, and he's very good for the group and for myself going forward. So, yeah, can't speak highly enough of him.